My name is Ron Monsager. I'm the program director for the anesthesia division here at the University of Minnesota College of Veterinary Medicine. The process of anesthesia starts with placing a catheter in the jugular vein on the horse's neck. And then usually the next step is we'll give a small dose of a sedative to calm the horse down. We rinse the horse's mouth out with some water to remove any food material that they tend to have in their mouth so that we don't put that into their airway once they're asleep. And then once that process is done, we walk them into the induction stall, put them behind a padded gate, and let them calm down and settle in there. And then we give a dose of a couple of different drugs to call induction drugs, which are given fairly rapidly intravenously. The horse is then rendered unconscious and slumps to the ground. At that point, we place a endotracheal tube into their airway. So it goes through the larynx into the trachea. And we use that to administer inhalant anesthesia, which keeps the horse asleep throughout the anesthetic period. Once the endotracheal tube is in place, then we hoist the horse with a hoist system, place them on the surgery table, attach our various monitoring devices so that we can start assessing the horse's condition at that point. And then the surgery team will, while we're doing that, the surgery team will prepare the horse for surgery, do any clipping of hair, prepping of the surgical site. And then we all roll into the surgery suite, perform the procedure, and then roll the horse out, disconnect it from our monitors and anesthesia machine, place in the recovery stall, and let the horse wake up. We've got a new recovery stall that is equipped with a walkway that we can look down over the top of a wall and watch the horse and be able to hear the horse as they're waking up. Much better visibility than we've ever had before. And we also have a new recovery flooring system that consists of an inflatable air pillow to cushion and protect the horse until they're ready to stand, to hopefully greatly reduce any risk of injury to the horse during the recovery process. So as we watch the horse wake up, we are primarily looking at their eyes and watching for twitchiness in the eyes, or what we call nystagmus, where their eyes roll back and forth from one side to another very quickly. As long as we see that, we know the horse is, although sort of awake, is probably not going to be able to stand well on their own at that point. And so we wait until a lot of that has resolved and gone away, and then kind of pull the plug on the mattress and allow the horse to have a firm foundation to stand upon at that point in time. We've put a lot of thought into how we've designed this facility so that the horse can very quickly and easily be moved from the induction process to get him on the surgery table, wheeled into the surgery suite, perform surgery, then wheeled straight out into the recovery stall, making it easy for us to work on the horse and also make it good for the horse as they go through the anesthetic process from start to finish.